Oxygen systems effective. Loading user interface.
Hey Mel, let me know if you're still good for our call tonight. Can't wait to hear about what you've uncovered today. Poppy says hi. Speak tonight. Love you.
Help me. Please.
Mayday. This is Commander Emma Sutcliffe of the Vitruvius mission. I am stranded in an unknown location following mission success. Are there any survivors out there?
Hello? This is Dr. Amelia Cross. I'm picking up your signal. I repeat, I am reading you clearly. Please, I don't know what's happened, but I need help.
Try and remain calm. Your systems are slightly damaged. I can't identify what your rank was either. Looks like you're suffering from cryogenic-induced amnesia.
What? What are you talking about?
You must have been part of Vitruvius, tasked with destroying the cube. Damn. The escape pods must have brought us both back to the origin planet. That life suit you're wearing, you can manipulate the cubic structures with it. We used the same design to destroy an extraterrestrial object that was on a collision course with Earth. You may not remember, but if you listen to me and do as I say, we may actually make it back home. Do you understand me?
I don't know what the hell is going on, but just tell me what I need to do.
Okay. I've detected a human distress beacon coming from the peak of the structure you're in. Your signal is weak because of this blasted sandstorm. I can't log on to you. That beacon is above the storm. If you can just make it there, you should be clear. If you rendezvous with any other survivors, I should be able to use my teleporter to extract us all and get home.
Right. Okay, I think I can do that.
Use the gloves you are wearing to change the structure around you. You should have access to the launch pad function, code-colored blue. Try placing one on any white cubes that have a frame using your left glove, then stand on it.
Jesus! I wasn't expecting that.
You better get used to it. It may just save your life in here. Listen, I'm losing signal because of the storm. Keep climbing upwards. Contact me if you find anything strange.
Hello? Can you hear me? God, what have I got myself into? Emma, I found something. Oh, still no signal.
Extrude function. Code colored red enabled. Recommended action. Place red cube on white panel.
What the? Why would these be here?
Thank you.
Emma, reading you loud and clear.
How are you doing?
Making progress, I think.
Good. Listen, I wanted to ask, what do you remember before waking up?
I don't. Not really. I think I was heading towards a job, a dig site in Scotland. I was in a helicopter with my team.
And you don't remember what happened?
No, I don't. Are you interrogating me, Emma? Because it sure as hell feels like it. Emma? Oh, God damn it, this stupid thing. I best continue. Another type. Interesting. It's like the structure itself can duplicate and grow. Emma, can you read me?
I'm reading you. Are you all right?
I've come across an exterior space. The storm has cleared up and, well, there's life here. There's water and plants.
That's unexpected.
This doesn't look accidental either. The structure of the space, the organization of it, it looks purposeful. It reminds me of my husband.
In what way?
Oh, he works with plants.
You should move on, Millie, before another storm comes.
Agreed. Speak soon.
Function. Code colored green enabled. Recommended action. Place green cube on white panel.
Incredible.
Green.
Does that mean I'm nearly at the top?
Not quite. These structures, all paths should lead to a central core. If you get there, we can figure out the best way to get you to the peak.
How do you know all of this?
We trained for a long time, Millie.
So what do you think these structures are?
Well, we know they have internal machinations and seem to perform tasks with no need for external input. A cybernetic system of sorts, reacting and adapting. The gloves were built to change that, or at least divert its functions temporarily.
But what's their purpose?
All I know is that we had to stop that vessel from colliding with Earth. The structure you're in, God knows what they're used for. Anyway, let's focus on finding that beacon as soon as possible. For you.
I want to become
one.
She said we would become
one. Don't leave me on my own.
Not without
her.
Emma.
What? What is it?
I think it's human, or was. Now I don't know what it is. A statue. And it was saying something. No, not saying. A radio transmission of sorts. I don't know. This is messed up.
Millie, whatever it was, it just means we need to find the location of that signal as soon as possible, okay? Then we can find a place to rendezvous.
Yeah, I understand. I'm sorry, I'm sorry.
It's fine, it's fine. Let's just keep going, okay?
Emma, I've emerged into a large chamber. Can you tell me how far I am from the beacon?
Your altitude shows that you're about halfway there.
There's a strange machine in here. I'm going to investigate it, see if it can help me find my way around this place. I can't decipher this, Emma. The language is like nothing I've ever seen. There are some things I can make out in illustration. Like, it seems to be a physical transportation machine. An elevator or monorail that ascends. It's hard to understand. It's connected to the three doorways by these large cables. I wonder if it's something that can be powered, taking us towards the beacon.
What was that?
I have no idea. But whatever it was, it seems to have turned this machine on and it's opened one of the doors.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to follow this cable and find out what this machine does.
Be careful, Millie.
Emma, can you read me?
I can. The signal's a lot better now.
Good. I found what these cables are connected to. It looks like a power reactor.
Do you think you can power it? Is it safe?
I don't know if it's safe for sure, but it certainly does something. There are four doorways connected to it via cables. One of them seems accessible. The door behind me is also locked, so it doesn't seem like I have much choice.
Okay. Follow the cable through the open door and see if there's a power source connected to it or a way to open these other rooms.
Got it. It looks like these cables lead through to more rooms. I'm gonna follow them, see if they connect to anything that can help power that central machine.
Good idea. Let me know if you find anything useful.
I've seen this technology before. I wonder what it does. Emma, that cable is connected to a terminal. It seems to have sent some form of energy back to that reactor and unlocked the other doors in this room. I'm going to check it out and follow the other cables attached to the reactor. Let's see what's behind these doors.
Maybe you're onto something here, Millie. Report on any changes.
Is that?
I think whatever you're doing in there is having an effect on the greater structure.
Let's hope it's a good thing. This reactor seems to be fully powered and is sending something back to that machine. I'm gonna check it out. Emma, from what I can tell, this machine is powered by a third, and another door connected to it has opened. How fascinating.
Okay, Millie, I trust your judgment. Let's see if it actually works as you think when all thirds are powered.
I'm on it. The reactor. Let's get this thing powered. Wonder what these are used for. Question.
What would you like to know?
So many things are running through my mind. I mean, you were sent to destroy that extraterrestrial object, right?
I was, as were many.
So, how did we develop this manipulation technology?
We tracked the vessel for years, since it entered the solar system, intercepting signals from it, decoding them. We learned about its structure, but not its host.
And you use this data to what? Develop this technology I'm wearing?
It was going to kill everyone on Earth, Millie. It was an invasion.
Sorry. I just need to orient myself. That's all. You've got to admit, this situation is somewhat out of the ordinary.
I know. This journey, it's not what I expected either, Millie.
No, I don't
think it's humane
to knock her away.
She needs
medical attention.
And she needs
to be looked after.
You don't know what you're dealing with,
James. So just do me a favor and
drop the
management
bullshit.
Okay, let's power these other rooms. Thank you. rumbling again. Emma, do you think this whole structure is some form of machine?
I don't know. The object that was going to collide with Earth, we thought it was a vessel, but after being on it, it was totally empty. Like it was a self-sufficient machine.
I guess we'll find out soon enough when the last third is powered. I hope this works.
Me too, Minnie.
Only one more reactor to power. Last one. Magnetism. You said that someone else destroyed the object. Who were they?
Some other scientist or military personnel that we sent.
Why did they send individuals? Why not teams?
To increase our chances. Each were jumped to different parts of the vessel, transported.
What? Like, teleported?
Yes. Some people lost their memory in tests. Others went mad. A portion were fine, of course. It was difficult to predict.
Is that what happened to me? I mean, how long have I been out for?
I don't know how long we've both been asleep, Millie. And yes, it's possible. Hopefully your memories will come back.
Something is
really wrong.
She's alive.
And reacting.
But I just can't get her to...
Let go of it!
Keep an eye on her.
And I'll call...
the extraction team.
See if they can
come in once early.
the last one powered.
It's time to find out what we've done.
Well, it's powered as far as I can tell. Now what?
Any clues on how to activate it? Okay, you're closing in on the beacon. I need you to locate any survivors. Once done, I'll see if I can lock onto your location. Then, with some hope, I'll try and extract us. Get us back.
Home.
Yeah. Can you read me?
What is it? What do you see?
This isn't a space vessel.
What do you mean?
The beacon. It's not coming from an escape pod. It's from a human helicopter. Like the one we used to travel to the dig site. Emma, where are we?
This doesn't make sense.
Emma, tell me where we are.
What's happening?